I would like to welcome you all to the world's largest LGBTQ workplace summit.
Welcome to Washington, D.C. Welcome to Summit. Welcome home.
There are so many different kinds of people here, so many stories to tell, so many things to learn. Whether you're going to the workshops, meeting up people between workshops to kind of create something new, or looking at what the exhibit hall has to offer, there is something for everyone here, and people should try it out.
Being able to come to Out and Equal gives me a chance to access that global community, to get to know other people and to learn their stories, because through learning their stories, that helps me be a better leader for Out and Equal, helps me be a better leader in my company and in my community.
I will be completely honest, it's probably one of the first spaces where I felt comfortable. I felt comfortable in my whole skin. I navigated through the halls and the workshops, and I met just amazing, amazing people who had time, who gave me time, who listened, who I listened to, who we all occupied space together when we weren't looking over our shoulder and we weren't worried.
There's something that's really healing about being in a space with people who are like-minded and people who are coming from different perspectives but are all coming together at this critical point. This work can be really lonely, especially at this time, and there's some critical healing that happens here that helps fill people's cups back up.
I mean, I just really don't have the energy to be anything other than myself.
All of a sudden, 6,000 people were standing and applauding and showing love to someone the best way they could in the moment, to someone who was anonymous because of a snowball, but who clearly needed, or who we believed clearly needed, to feel some of that love and energy. And they got it 6,000 times over, which was incredibly impactful, I think, for everyone in the room. I don't think anyone will ever forget that exercise.
It's so important that we all know that we're not in this alone. We can reach out to other people that are strangers that we don't know and be there for them, just to help them through whatever. And I think that's kind of goes to like the root of life. Like we have to help each other when we're strong enough to do so. And he definitely did so. And it's nice to know that there's somebody that's there no matter what.
We're not going anywhere. We have a tough year ahead of us, and every time you feel alone, remember this moment, this tribe that is surrounding you right now, and know that we aren't going anywhere. None of us are free until all of us are free, and we are not done until all of us are protected.